السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ونستعين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. كل عام وأنتم بخير. Today is the 14th day of Ramadan. And inshallah we'll be doing two surahs, سورة الإسراء وسورة الكهف. Both surahs are of the greatest surah. And I'll try to cover just the highlights, hit the high notes of these surahs. سورة الإسراء, it is hitting a main thing very, very important. It's the year 10th, the Prophet ﷺ has gone through the sorrow of the death of his uncle, the death of his wife Khadija, and he has gone to Ta'if, and things are looking bad. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving him and us that night. And in the first verse, we know who is going from where to where. And it starts by سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. Then in the Quran there is سبح, سبح اسم ربك الأعلى. There is يسبح, there is سبحان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to be glorified in the past, in the present, in the future, for all times. And he took his slave, his worshipper, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, from Masjid al-Haram in Mecca to al-Masjid al-Aqsa, to night journey. ليريه من آياتنا. So that's from the beginning. And then two other ayat after that. One is وَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابِ, and the other ذُرِيَّةِ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. The banner of da'wah was with the believers at the time of Nuh. And these were the believers who were on the ark of Nuh. Everybody else was destroyed. رَبِّ لَا تَجْعَلْ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ دَيَّارًا. Everybody died except those who held the banner were those with Nuh. And the banner was carried there by the believers of the Israelites for the longest period. And Isra was carrying the banner to the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was the imam of the prayers over there. This is the part of the Isra, the Mi'raj, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us all with the salah. Alhamdulillah. The following ayat is speaking about وقضينا إلى بني إسرائيل في الكتاب لتفسدن في الأرض مرتين ولا تعلن علوا كبيرا. That you are going to do corruption in the land and you are going to come to a great height. And scholars differ. Did these two events already happen? Did one of them happen? The other is due to come later on, بعد الآخرة, or both did not happen so far. And one of the scholars said, doesn't matter. What matters is what's mentioned later on. وإن عدتم عدنا. Anytime there is a corruption, you will be destroyed. Whomever. Anybody, people decide to do corruption, they are going to be destroyed. وَإِنْ عُدْتُمْ عُدْنَا. Then, since the banner is there, what is the banner that the Prophet ﷺ had? It's the Quran. And Surah Al-Isra is all about the Quran. More than 10 times in Surah Al-Isra, the word Quran is mentioned. The biggest in any Surah of the Quran. It starts from the beginning, إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنون الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا. Surely the Quran guides to what is most upright and gives good news to the believers who do good, that they will have a mighty reward. Then over 18 آيات that starts لا تجعل مع الله إلها آخر and ends لا تجعل مع الله إلها آخر. Don't associate in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anybody. Don't associate in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anybody. And there is 18 ayah in the middle. This is what the Quran is telling us. This is what we are carrying the banner for. And it takes from the beginning, after no association with the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, take care of your parents, take care of the relatives, take care of the poor, take care of the wayfarer. Don't overspend, don't be a miser, be in the middle. Don't kill your kids for fear of poverty. Don't even come close to adultery. Don't kill any human soul. Don't come near money that belongs to an orphan. If there is any trade, be just. When you don't know something, don't start saying, لَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِي عِلْمٍ. If you don't know, you don't know. And the last is humility. لَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرْحًا. When you walk, walk in a nice way, in a decent way. Don't be, stay with humility and being humble. The word Quran is mentioned. وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ يَذَّكَّرُوا مَا يَزِيدُهُمْ إِلَّا نُفُورًا. We have surely varied the signs in the Quran. so that they will be mindful. Second, وإذا قرأت القرآن جعلنا بينك وبين الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة حجابا مستورا. When you, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite the Quran, we put a hidden barrier between you and those who do not believe in the hereafter. Then, وإذا ذكرت ربك في القرآن وحده ولوا على أدبارهم نفورا. And if you mention your Lord alone in the Quran, they turn their backs, the non-believers, in aversion. Then again, the word Quran, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about a شجرة الملعونة في القرآن, that there was a dream that the Prophet saw about a cursed tree that's in hellfire, and it's mentioned in the Quran. Then you go through أقم الصلاة لدلوك الشمس إلى غسق الليل وقرآن الفجر إن قرآن الفجر كان مشهودا. And twice you are hearing the word Quran. Establish prayer at the decline of the sun until the darkness of the night, and recite the Quran at the dawn. Indeed, recitation of Quran at the dawn time is being witnessed by angels. Very good time for recitation of Quran. What is the Quran? وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. We send down the Quran as a healing and mercy to the believers. Challenging again, we heard the challenge in Surah Yunus, we heard it in so many surahs, in Surah Hud. And here, قل لئن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا مثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله. Say, O Prophet, tell them, if all the human and jinn would to come together to produce an equivalent of this Quran, they could not produce its equal. وَلْقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا النَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ فَأَبَى أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ إِلَّا كُفُورًا. And we have truly set forth every kind of lesson for humanity in this Quran, yet most people persist in belief, in disbelief. And it concludes, وَبِالْحَقِّ أَنزَلْنَاهُ وَبِالْحَقِّ نَزَلْ. It does not mention the word Quran here, but it's referring to the Quran that it was sent, descended on you, Muhammad, in truth. وَقُرْآن, it is the Quran we have revealed in stages. The end, that the Quran was mentioned over 23, was revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam over 23 years, so that you may recite it to people at deliberate paces. So more than 10 times we are hearing the word Quran. The nation of Islam is carrying the banner. This is the constitution. It is to be read, it's to be implemented, it's to be understood as much as we can. It's to be tadabbur al-Quran, which is mentioned in four different surah, afala yatadabbaruna al-Quran, four different times in the Quran. It's mentioned that we should reflect on the Quran to understand it. So Surah Al-Isra is surah about the Quran, but the link also that we should not forget between Al-Masjid Al-Haram and Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. The link that is there, the link that has been started from the beginning of time, the link that has to stay till the end of time, inshallah. I'm going to move to Surah Al-Kahf. And Surah Al-Kahf is about trials that we face. Human beings face different type of trials. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us four different types of trial. It starts by Alhamdulillah anzala ala abidi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. All praises be to Allah who has revealed the book, the Quran, to his servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, allowing no crookedness in it. Then we start with the first fitna, and this is the fitna of thabat ala da'wa, somebody who has to stay steadfast in the following up of the religion of Islam. You have to hold your grounds when you are on the. Here is a story of people who embraced the faith, stood firm. They had to run away. And everybody knows the story. Their numbers we do not know. They stayed there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even made the sun change its course. Tazawar an kafihim. And they stayed there. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused them to wake up after 309 years. And even the conversation that they had after they woke up. إِنَّهُمْ إِنْ يَظْهَرُوا عَلَيْكُمْ يَرْجُمُكُمْ. That if they win against, they are thinking that they are waking and they're still the old regime, they are going to maybe stone you. But what is worse, that they might let you get away from your religion. That's even worse than being stoned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not leave us with the story, but he tells us how to protect ourselves against this fitna. One is أتل ما أوحي إليك من كتاب ربك لا مبدل لكلماته. Recite the Quran. Recite what has been revealed to you from the book of your Lord. Second, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِي يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ. Hold yourself, stick patiently to those who are memorizing Quran, reading Quran, deliberating on the Quran, deliberating on the religion in general, and so on. وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ. And this is told to Prophet Muhammad and to us. Have patience, stay with them. وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ. Don't ever steer away from them. Always stick to these people who are on the right track. Third, وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبُهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ وَكَانَ أَمْرُهُ فُرُطًا. Don't ever listen to those who have gone astray. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us how to protect ourselves from fitna, to stay in, against the, this fitna. The second fitna, wealth, money. And we have seen this in the story of Qarun in Surah Al-Qasas. And here is the example of the two men. One of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him so many, many things. And yet he thinks that he has gained this by himself. And not only that, he's saying, even if I end up, even if there is a day of judgment, I'll still have a high stand over there. And he gets the answer from his fellow human being, لولا إذ دخلت جنتك قلت ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. If only you had said, referring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you everything. When you enter your property, this is what Allah has willed. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with that. It's not like Qarun, نما أتيت على علم عندي. I got it because of my knowledge, because of this and that. No, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no power except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also give us how to protect ourselves. And he gives us a parable. The likeness of all this dunya, الحياة الدنيا, is like rain coming down. Here is you have a crops that's growing, and all of a sudden, هشيم تذره الرياح, it's coming something that the wind will blow away. That's the whole dunya. It's not staying forever, it's staying for a very short time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also is telling us, yes, المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا. Having kids, having money, having kids, is something, an ornament of this dunya. But الباقيات الصالحات خير. And people have gone trying, scholar have trying to interpret what's the باقيات الصالحات, everlasting good deeds. And they said the best باقيات الصالحات is لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. But any good deed is what's really staying. Any investment that we have for the hereafter is a good deed, rather than sticking to this dunya. Third trial is the trial that humility of knowledge. When Musa alayhi salam is being asked who is the most knowledgeable person on earth, and he says, I am. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, go to a person or go to somebody, we don't know if he's a person or not, go to somebody who is more knowledgeable than you. And we hear the story of Al-Khidr, although the name is not mentioned in the Quran, and Prophet Musa and his fatah. إِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِفَتَاهُ لَا أَبَرَ حَتَّى أَبْلُغْ مَجْمَعَ الْبَحْرَيْنَ أَمْضِي حُقُبًا. Remember when Moses said to his young assistants, I'll never give up until I reach the junction of the two seas, even if I travel for ages. And he goes and he follows him, and we hear about three different stories. And Musa does not understand the interpretation. He does not have any patience. And then at the end, the interpretation is told to him, in order to have the humility of knowledge. ذَلِكَ تَأْوِيلُ مَا لَمْ تَسْطِعْ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا. This is the expression, what you cannot have patience. So always have humility in your knowledge. And the fourth is when you have power, and that was ذُلْقَرْنَيْن. وَيَسْأَلُكَ عَنْ ذُلْقَرْنَيْن. They ask you about ذُلْقَرْنَيْن. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about his trips, north and east and so on, and how he was a very judge person. Surah Al-Kahf concludes with a very good thing. How to know if you are on the right track or not the wrong track? قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Say, O Muhammad, shall we not inform you of those who are greatest losers? Those whose efforts are in vain in the worldly life while they think they are doing good? It's they who reject the signs of their Lord. Ayat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it's the Holy Scripture, the Quran, or whatever signs, the sun, the moon, the sea, everything around us. They reject the signs of their Lord and meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rendering their deeds void, as if it was not done. That's the reward, hellfire. Indeed, those who believe and do good will have gardens of paradise as an accommodation where they will forever, never desiring anywhere else. Here we have the dwellers of hellfire and the, inshallah, those who يَرِثُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ, those who live in paradise. Say, O Prophet, if the ocean was ink, قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرِ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتُ رَبِّي, for writing the words of my Lord, it would certainly run out before the words of my Lord would finished, even if they were filled with its equal. Two great surahs, Surah Al-Isra, Surah Al-Kahf. Allahumma ya Rabbi Rahman Rahim, this is the month that you revealed the Quran at. Allahumma ya Rabbi Rahman Rahim, ارزقنا صيامه وارزقنا قيامه يا رب العالمين. اللهم اعنا على قيامه واجعل الله فيها خير ايامنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم يا رب يا رحمن يا رحيم, اللهم افتح لنا ابواب جنتك واغلق ابواب نيرانك يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل دعاءنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم قربنا منا الى مرضاتك يا رب العالمين, وجنبنا سخطك ونقمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم انك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم انك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم انك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خيرا.